Hey guys, it's Nick from Nick's Taxes, back with another video. Today we're going to talk a little bit more about the Canada budget that was recently released by our federal Liberal government, and we're going to focus more on our seniors. Now, in most of my videos, I seem to get a lot of comments from people asking, what's going on for seniors, or what's going on to help people with disabilities? And so in today's video, we're going to talk a little bit more on some things that can help our seniors and can help those who have disabilities. There are programs out there, as you may know, that helps these groups of people. And so in today's video, we're going to highlight those things and also touch on what might be coming as a result of the current budget that was recently released. If you want to go back and look at the highlight video that I did regarding the budget, I made a quick 10-minute video kind of summarizing some of the major things that will affect you, and I'll link that video up here so you can go and check that out once this video is over. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing. I make videos on personal tax, finance, and investing, as well as things like the Canada Recovery Benefits and those kind of things. So very much a Canadian spin on a lot of these financial topics. So if this is of interest to you, please consider subscribing, and I would ask that you quickly take the time to give this video a thumbs up. Helps my channel grow, helps the YouTube algorithm, and I'd really appreciate that. So please do that now, and we will jump into the content. First thing I want to talk about regarding the budget is this new bump up for seniors over the age of 75. So if you are 75 or older as of June 2022, you're going to receive a one-time $500 payment in August of 2021. This is not official yet, but this is the plan. If you remember, or if you were a senior last year, you had a one-time payout, I believe, of $300 last year, and they said that was to help seniors for, you know, the increased costs that were related to the pandemic. So this year, they're looking at a one-time $500 payout. And the budget is also proposing a 10% increase to the old age security payments. And that would be for pensioners aged 75 or older, starting in July of 2022. If this goes as planned, this would provide additional benefits of $766 to full pensioners in the first full year and would impact around 3.3 million seniors. So this is quite a bit of you guys, quite a bit of Canadians that this will touch, and hopefully it will help them cover some of their expenses that they have and the increasing costs that we're experiencing right now. So that's for our seniors age 75 and older. I mentioned that in the highlight video as well, and some of you were like, hey, what about the other group of seniors that are under 75? Well, it doesn't look like you're going to get that piece of the pie, but I want to talk about some tax credits and benefits that are available to our seniors potentially that you guys can access in order to save more money from a tax perspective. Obviously, we just finished tax season, so I hope everyone watching this video has filed and paid their taxes by April 30th. If not, go do so as soon as possible. But let's take a look at some benefits that might be able to help you guys get more money. So these here are for seniors and for those who are in disabilities. It's not always the case, but often we see seniors that also qualify for a lot of disability credits and whatnot. So I'm gonna lump this together as one kind of content piece. So you don't necessarily have to be a senior. You can be qualified for these disabilities, or you could be a senior with these disabilities. I'm gonna lump it all together. But obviously, you guys are subject to the common deductions that everyone else has available, things like childcare expenses, investing into your spouse's RSP or your own RSP. One thing I want to talk about today is the disability tax credit, and I made a video on that previously, and I'm going to talk about it a little bit more today. The disability tax credit is a non-refundable tax credit, which means it can reduce the amount of tax you have to pay down to zero. And it also includes a supplement for children under 18. You say, hey, Nick, I don't have any taxable income. What's the point of doing this then with this non-refundable tax credit? Well, you are also able to transfer this credit to a spouse or a dependent or someone else along those lines so that they can benefit from your disability tax credit. So you are able to transfer that to someone else. Who is eligible for the disability tax credit? Well, people who have a mental or physical impairment that impacts their basic activities of daily living and or needs dedicated time for life-sustaining therapy are eligible. So on the CRA website, it says that if it takes you an inordinate amount of time to do a common task, you might qualify for the disability tax credit. There's mental and the physical side, so it could be things like vision, it could be things like mobility, and then obviously things related to mental as well. So there's many different things out there that could put you in this disability tax credit category. Also, the impairment that you have has to have lasted or is expected to last for a period of 12 consecutive months in order to qualify. So when you're applying for this, you have to do a little bit of work. You don't just file this on the tax return. You have to get approval from a medical professional. So that medical professional has to file out a T2201 tax form. It's a disability certificate, basically. And then you send that into the CRA, and the CRA gives you approval to now therefore qualify for the tax credit. So once you get that approval, you can apply for the tax credit on your current tax return. Or you can go back as far as 10 years, if this has been a lasting disability, you can go back as far as 10 years and amend those tax returns. And if you amend those tax returns to claim the credit, you'll get refunds for every year that you're claiming the credit, obviously. There really is no harm in applying to see if you're eligible. If you're not eligible, there's no penalty or anything against you for trying or even talking to your medical professionals about seeing if you could qualify for this sort of credit. I also talked about dependents under 18. Children could also qualify for a disability amount, and it could be things related to things like ADHD, autism, bipolar disorder, epilepsy, learning disabilities, or anxiety disorders. If your children have any of those or more, I will have them linked in the description. Your children could also qualify for the disability tax credit. If this sounds a little bit complicated to you, I've actually teamed up with a group called Grants International, and I've made a video with them previously. But the role at Grants International is they actually help you along this process for getting approval for this disability tax credit. As I've said, there are steps that you need to take in order to qualify, and Grants International helps walk you through those steps to make sure that you do indeed qualify. And once you receive that approval, they help you file your tax returns. So if you want help, Grants International can do so. All you have to do is click the link below. All you have to do is click the link below, and they can guide you through the process and help you out. There's no obligation to fill out the form. They will contact you and they will start the process with you. The other thing with them is they don't get paid unless you get paid. So if you qualify and you get approved and then you get your refund back, then you pay Grants International. There's no cost for you to work with them in order to get approval for this benefit. So if you think that you are someone who could fit this disability tax credit, or you have a loved one who might qualify for the disability tax credit, it doesn't help to fill out the form in the description below and see if Grants International can help you. They are the refund experts, so this is their niche, this is their area of expertise. So I recommend reaching out to them and seeing if they can help you out. So those are some things that are going to help the seniors and those who fit in the disabled category. I hope you got value out of this video. If you want more tips and tricks, please let me know in the comments below. And as always, I just ask that you give this video a thumbs up. It really helps my channel. Appreciate it. And I will see you guys in the next video. Happy taxing.